so many times God allowed us to suffer. Maybe this year, or maybe in the years to come, God will allow something to happen in us. To cause us maybe, or us to think that God has deserted us, or God has blocked our communication to heaven. Allowed problems to come our way. We have been through a lot of calamities and disasters. Our family are broken. Husband or children are not communicating with us. Our friend has just forsaken us. Is God good? If you are one of the residents in the flooding Queensland in Australia, can you with boldness say, God is good? If you say, yung bubong ng bahay mo nawala, God is good. If you say, yung sasakyan nyo, your car is floating, you say, well, God is good, it makes my car float. We still have the reason to celebrate the goodness of the Lord in the midst of trying times. Why? Because the goodness of God is great, greater than our sufferings, problems. The faithfulness of God is greater than all our sufferings and problems. The good or the love of God is greater than all our sufferings and problems. A poem was seen in the pocket of an unknown Civil War veteran, and later was displayed in the lobby of the Shreveport in Los Angeles Veterans Hospital that goes, and he entitled it, Most Richly Blessed. He said, I asked God for strength that I might achieve. I was made weak that I might learn humbly to obey. I asked God for health that I might do great things. I was given infirmity that I might do better things. I asked God for riches that I might be happy. I was given poverty that I might become wise. I asked God for power that I might have the praise of men. I was given weakness that I might feel the need for God. Because if you are rich, you don't have the feel of God. I asked for all things that I might enjoy life. I was given life that I might enjoy all things. I got nothing that I asked for. Nothing. It's just like God has shut the heaven for me. I got nothing from what I prayed for. But everything I had hoped for. Almost despite myself, my unspoken prayers and true needs were fulfilled. I am, he said, I am among all men most richly blessed. Can you say this afternoon, amidst sufferings and painful trials, problems in your life, can you still say, oh, God is good, my God is great, his faithfulness on you, and I am still among all men most richly blessed.
Amen.
And that's the very reason why we're here this afternoon. We're celebrating the goodness of God because we knew that we are still men, among the children of God, among people in this world, are most richly blessed by God.
Amen.
Thus we need to celebrate the goodness of the Lord in our life. Can you say with me, I am among men,
amen,
most richly blessed.
Blessed.
Shall we pray? Our gracious God and loving Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your love. Indeed, we have all the reasons to rejoice. We have all the reasons to celebrate. Because Jeremiah, the prophet, said, that your love is greater than our sufferings. Your faithfulness is greater than our sufferings. Your goodness is greater than our sufferings. And so we declare your faithfulness, your greatness in our midst this afternoon, Lord. And we worship you. And we celebrate your goodness at this time. You are a faithful, loving God that we are serving and we are worshiping. While your heads are bowed and as your eyes are closed, I do not know what sufferings or what pains you are in right now, to the point that sometimes you forget to thank God and to praise God and to worship God. But seeing then from His Word that He is faithful, He is loving, He is good, would you thank Him this time and say, Lord, I'm sorry. Sometimes my focus is on my needs, on my problems. I have forgotten to focus my attention, my eyes on you, Father God. But thank you for reminding me once again that you are a faithful God. Or maybe as a church, you say, Lord, as a church, we have been focusing on so minor things. We are majoring on minors in our lives. And as a church, we are focusing on attendance. We are focusing on activities. We are focusing on whatever aspects in our churches, to the point that we have forgotten that we are serving a faithful, good, and loving God. And can you say as a church, Lord, we are sorry for not focusing on you. We are sorry for focusing on material rather than the spiritual. We're sorry for focusing on ourselves rather than God. But starting today, help us to celebrate your goodness in the midst of crying times, to rejoice in the midst of sadness or trying times, because we know that our God is faithful and good and loving. Or maybe you are here this afternoon, your first time to attend this church, and you have not yet accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. I tell you, you cannot experience the goodness and the faithfulness of God unless and until you are one of His children. What you are experiencing right now is nothing but the universal blessings of the Lord for the world. But if you would like to have a personal and specific blessings from God, you need to start it by accepting Him as your personal Lord and Savior. That is the first blessing that you can ever receive from a faithful and loving and good God. Will you say to Him, Lord, I acknowledge that I am a sinner. I've been living in a life without acknowledging you, without even knowing you. But now thank you. I know your attributes. I know your character. You are good. You are faithful. Only to those who put their hope or trust in you. And this afternoon, I want to put my trust in you. I believe you. I accept you as my personal Lord and Savior. Come into my life. Make me the kind of person you want me to be. Or maybe this afternoon you are here. You have so many problems in your life as a Christian. Somehow, these problems make you slow in your spiritual growth. Would you then say to the Lord, Lord, I have so many problems. But thank you because you have given me a truth that I can still rejoice in the midst of this problem. What I need to do is to give you all my problems. It's to give you all my sufferings. What I need to declare is my big God in the midst of minor problems in my life. So whatever things that God has spoken to you this afternoon, I pray that you would talk it back to God and let God deal with it this afternoon. Our Father, thank you very much, Lord, for talking to us. We do not know how you have talked to us this afternoon, but it's my prayer that you would bless our desires, our commitment, our prayers this afternoon. We thank you and we bring back all the glory and honor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the faithful one. We pray. Amen.